जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12 ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल, वेलकम। दिस इज अ स्पेशल क्लास ऑर्गेनाइज्ड फॉर यू फॉर रिवीजन, एज इन दिस मंथ यू आर हैविंग वन सीबीटी कंप्यूटर बेस्ड टेस्ट। द टेस्ट विल कंटेन मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस 30 मार्क्स। यू हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन वन टेस्ट इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल, सो यू आर यूज्ड टू to do the question answer, how you have to attempt the test, everything. I am going to discuss today what the syllabus we have completed in the month of July between 6th to 31st. We will finish already in between 6th to 31st July. Will be the matter for your multiple choice question, and based on these contents only questions will be asked in your test. Now see, in first book we have discussed primary activities, tertiary and quaternary activities, and book 2 we have discussed human development of India, human settlements, we have discussed water resources. So these 5 lessons are there important for you, and from these 5 lessons only the questions will be there in your question paper. So very first I am starting with second book, and the topic is human development. What type of question can be asked? What type of question? Actually, as we are discussing of human development in India, we know that in India human development is not equal all over the part of our country. Bharat mein human development, ek to Bharat ka world mein bahut acha rank nahi hai, aur Bharat mein interview agar dekhen to Kerala magar HDI highest pe hai, तो बाद में छत्तीसगढ़ वगैरह स्टेट में बहुत कम है, बहुत खराब है ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट। तो इस लेसन से पर्टिकुलरली ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट से ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट होता गया है, इसके कौन कौन से मेन की एरियाज हैं इससे रिलेटेड मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस। इसके अलावा ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट इन इंडिया स्टेट वाइज रैंक, इससे रिलेटेड मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन, या इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट लाइक इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक अटेनमेंट, indicators of social empowerment, indicators of healthy life, literacy is also very important to know. At per census 2011, now what is the total literacy of India, male literacy, female literacy, where is the lowest female literacy, where is the highest female literacy, which states are mostly literate, achieved around 100% of literacy. All such things are here in this lesson, particularly can be asked for multiple choice questions. इसके अलावा population, environment and development, population, environment and development एक टॉपिक है, इसमें खास करके स्वच्छ भारत मिशन के बारे में पढ़े हैं, और क्या क्या population के बढ़ने से environmental degradation कैसे हो रहा है और हम लोग क्या करना चाहिए, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ऑल दिस थिंग्स। फ्रॉम हियर ऑल्सो मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट्स, स्पेशली सेकेंड बुक इंडिया पीपल एंड इकोनॉमी, ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट। इन ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट द बेसिक क्राइटेरिया और द मेन बेसिस फॉर डिफरेंशिएशन बिटवीन द रूरल एंड अर्बन पॉपुलेशन, रूरल एंड अर्बन एरियाज ऑलरेडी गिवन टू योर बुक, मस्ट रिवाइज वंस अगेन। फ्रॉम हियर मेनी मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन कैन बी फ्रेम्ड। Types of rural settlement, types of rural settlement, as you can recall, clustered, semi-clustered, hamleted, dispersed. So with example this type of questions will be asked. Side by side the mega cities of India, then can be asked about the medieval town, modern town and ancient towns in India, and based on the functional, you can say functional classification of town based on their functions of cities mainly. Each and every function nowadays are there in all cities, but which is dominating over all these functions, accordingly that we are classifying the city called, suppose like industrial town, cantonment, garrison cantonment town, tourism town, etc. So accordingly, so there is a functional classification of towns also. Here from number of questions can be asked, so here is the scope Which cities are known as class 1 cities? Which cities are called as metropolitan cities? And which cities are called as mega cities? All such questions are there for a multiple choice question. Side by side, suppose I am asking one question. Which one of the following towns is not located on a river bank? I am giving you four options. Listen. Agra, Bhopal, Patna, Kolkata. Now think. Agra is located the bank of Yamuna. Bhopal, there is the lake, no river. Patna is located at the bank of Ganga. And Kolkata is at the bank of Hugli River, a distributary of Ganga. In the same way, number of questions can be asked. Suppose, which one of the following is a religious town? Jamshedpur, Varanasi, Mumbai, none of these. Varanasi, of course, it is also an educational town too. From ancient time, the city has great importance and believed to be the oldest city of India. As per classification in the world, the oldest city now is declared Jerusalem. But we Indian believe that Kashi, now Varanasi, Kashi is the oldest city of the world. It is the oldest of India, no doubt. Then, land resources and agriculture is not there to discuss this time. This lesson will be discussed at last for the time we will get. But water resources can recall. It is a long lesson, water resources. And from water resources, many questions can be asked. For example, what is the total area of India, geographical area of India, of the world? How much population is there? How much total world's water resources are available there in our country in percentage? Suppose 4%. Based on these questions can be asked. The total water available for precipitation in the country in a year, about how much cubic kilometer? And the total eligibility water resources in the country, how much? All such questions, as well as the mean annual flow in all the river basins in India estimated to be dash kilometer. So from this such type of data, questions or MCQ can be asked. Yahan se question puche jaate hain generally. Iske alawa basin wise ग्राउंड वाटर पोटेंशियल यूटिलाइजेशन से रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन आएगा. ग्राउंड वाटर या सरफेस वाटर दोनों का यूटिलाइजेशन किस सेक्टर में ज्यादा हो रहा है, इससे क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. जो मेजर सेक्टर्स हैं, डोमेस्टिक, इंडस्ट्रियल और एग्रीकल्चर, सरफेस वाटर किसमें ज्यादा यूज हो रहा है, ग्राउंड वाटर किसमें ज्यादा यूज हो रहा है, ये सब है मैटर, इससे क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. इसके अलावा डिमांड ऑफ वाटर फॉर इरीगेशन, इससे भी रिलेटेड कुछ एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. जैसे फॉर डैश रीजन देयर इज नीड ऑफ मोर वाटर फॉर इरिगेशन, फॉर डैश रीजन फॉर द बेटर प्रोडक्शन. इसके अलावा और भी तीन ऑप्शन रहेगा, नॉन ऑफ दीजिए रहेगा, जो भी. तो ऑप्शन आपको मिलेगा, जो बेस्ट सुटेड ऑप्शन है उसको आपको अटेम्प्ट करना है. देन डिटोरिएशन ऑफ वाटर क्वालिटी, फ्रॉम हियर नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड. Water conservation and management, it is also important topic. From here, number of questions can be asked, like Haryali is a watershed development project sponsored by central government, and in which area? It is in Rajasthan, Haryali, Meru and Meru in Andhra Pradesh. First type of question for MCQ are very important. How we can prevent water pollution? What are the main pollutants? Based on this, recycle and reuse of water. तो इस तरह जितने भी टॉपिक दिया, वाटर सेड मैनेजमेंट, इससे रिलेटेड इंपॉर्टेंट बॉक्स इंफॉर्मेशन भी वी हैव डिस्कस, दैट इज द वाटर सेड डेवलपमेंट इन रालीगांव सिद्धि अहमदनगर महाराष्ट्र, अ केस स्टडी वी हैव डिस्कस. फ्रॉम हियर मल्टीपल क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड. साथ ही साथ हम लोग को ये देखना होगा रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग, उसका ऑब्जेक्टिव इसको समझिएगा. लेसन को थोरली पढ़ना है. You have to go through each and every content as well as even the box informations. All they are very important. Because the MCQ questions are not meant only for your test, for your board exam also. 18 MCQ questions will be there in your final board exam. So far, you have to prepare each and every aspect of the NCERT as given either in box information, they are also important. Then we have to discuss about the national water policy. You have to go through this, and many features are mentioned already. The key feature, you can say, of the national water policy 2002, here from multiple choice question can be asked. One question I am asking: which one of the following river has the highest replenishable groundwater resource in the country? Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra, or Godavari? Obviously, it is Ganga. Ganga basin is the most important river basin for our country, because the maximum flow of Ganga, which is originating from Indian territory in Uttarakhand, Uttarkashi, and very little part is there in Bangladesh. So it is the important river basin, having highest replenishable groundwater. Likewise, another question: which one of the following South Indian state had the highest groundwater utilization in percent? So all this data and table as given to this lesson, you have to prepare. As in the question, I am repeating once again: which one of the following South Indian states has the highest groundwater utilization in percent of its total groundwater potential? सबसे ज़्यादा use कहाँ हो रहा है इसके potential का? Already box, there are number of table given. From table question like percentage of net irrigated area by wells and tube wells, it is another table. So all such can be asked as multiple choice questions. In first book, especially, I am not discussing question answer. I am just giving you the clue how you have to prepare. So lesson we have discussed are the primary activities. It is a long lesson. Primary activities. In primary activities, we have discussed about the primary activities. We have discussed about the hunting and gathering, supposed to be the oldest human economic activities. We have discussed about the pastoralism, nomadic herding also. In this part, a lot of multiple choice questions are here, as well as we have discussed about the commercial livestock rearing. Suppose one example I am giving for a multiple choice question: which one of the following type of livestock rearing emphasized over a single type of animal rearing? Nomadic herding, commercial livestock rearing, mixed farming, none of these. It is commercial livestock rearing. A single type of animal is reared. इस तरह से बहुत सारा MCQ question बनेगा इस सारे parts से. इसके अलावा agriculture, types of agriculture. Basically दो तरह का agriculture होता है, subsistence और दूसरा commercial. Subsistence agriculture further divided into two parts. Primitive subsistence agriculture or slash and burn, इसका बहुत सारा नाम है वर्ड में, इससे related question. और दूसरा intensive subsistence agriculture, इसका भी two further division है. Intensive subsistence agriculture dominated by wet paddy cultivation, और दूसरा है intensive subsistence agriculture dominated by crops other than paddy. तो ये सब जो part है, इसको अच्छे से ready करना है आपको. From here, questions can be asked. Plantation agriculture. Who have introduced plantation agriculture? Especially the Europeans in their colonies. As Britishers have introduced tea plantation in India, especially in northeast, in parts of North Bengal, in Darjeeling. Today, India is one of the leading producer and exporter of tea in the world. Only China and Turkey are producing more than India. They are the third largest producer now. So, from plantation agriculture, suppose one question I am quoting here. The large plantation of coffee in Brazil are generally known as gardens, coffee farm, fazendas, none of these. बड़े coffee farm को क्या बोलते हैं? मुझे generally fazendas बोलते हैं Brazil में. इस तरह के MCQ question आ सकते हैं. Extensive commercial grain farming, इससे related भी question आता है, कौन कौन से region में है. Especially this type of agriculture best developed in Eurasian steppes, Canadian and American prairies. It means the temperate grassland or mid latitude grassland. Mixed farming, Mediterranean agriculture, iska main motive. Mediterranean agriculture ka main product kya hai? Ye kahan kahan pe hota hai? what is viticulture, why grapes are produced at large scale in this Mediterranean climatic region, what is market gardening, what is horticulture, crop farming, cooperative farming, so number of types of farming are given, collective farming, etc. So from any one of the type of farming, number of questions are sent. So you have to go through detail, you have to go through each and every continent, and you have to prepare all the continents, even the box information also. Then the last topic in this lesson is the mining. How many types of mining are there? Generally there are basically two types, surface mining and underground mining, which requires advanced technologies is the underground mining, and easy and cheapest way is the surface mining. Say related bhi bahut sara question aayega. Suppose a question push round, listen, which one of the following is not a plantation crop? Which one of the following is not a plantation crop? Here I am trying to find out your understanding. Coffee, sugarcane, wheat, rubber. So you must know that coffee, sugarcane, rubber are the plantation crops. So which option is correct? Wheat. It is not a plantation crop. Likewise, in which of the following countries cooperative farming was the most successful? Russia, Denmark, India, Netherlands. So it is Denmark. So you have to go through the entire content. कोई भी content skip नहीं करना है. Question कहीं से भी बन सकता है. Which one of the following does not follow monoculture? Monoculture माने single cropping, एक ही तरह के crop लगाना. Monoculture follow नहीं करता है. Dairy farming, mixed farming, plantation और commercial grain farming. Simply the mixed farming. So varieties of crops are grown as well as animal rearing is also going on. So first type of question will be asked. Secondary activity is not there, we have not discussed, but the tertiary and quaternary activities you have discussed in detail. From this lesson, multiple choice question can be framed from many parts, especially from the service sector. You have gone through the flow chart related to this. Trade and commerce, retail trading, wholesale trading, etc. are the matter where from. Even the box information in these lessons are very important for board even. Like what is a network, what is a node. Based on this, multiple choice question can be asked. What are chain stores? Likewise, transport, factors of affecting transport. Likewise, telecommunications, people engaged in tertiary activities, or khas karke tourist attractions. मेडिकल सर्विसेज, क्वार्टनरी और क्वाइनरी सर्विसेज, इसके बारे में बहुत अच्छे से आपको देखना है. साथ साथ कलर ऑफ द कॉलर, कलर ऑफ द कॉलर एक्सरसाइज में है, एंड नेचर ऑफ वर्क. सपोज रेड कॉलर वर्कर, इसको बोलते हैं द पीपल हु आर एंगेज्ड इन प्राइमरी एक्टिविटीज. गोल्ड कॉलर, द पीपल हु आर एंगेज्ड इन क्वीनरी एक्टिविटीज. इसमें बेस्ट भी है, मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन आ सकता है, इसको भी आपको अच्छे से प्रिपेयर करना है. आई मोटिव इज हियर टू इनकल्केट द आइडिया टू प्रिपेयर योर एग्जामिनेशन एज यू आर गोइंग टू टेक एग्जामिनेशन फॉर योर बेटर मार्क्स. नंबर आपका अच्छा आना है, यू हैव टू वर्क हार्ड. साथ साथ ध्यान रखना है, जल्दीबाजी नहीं करना है. विल हैव एनफ टाइम फॉर कंप्लीटिंग द पेपर. फर्स्ट see which questions are there which you can take easily and you know the answers correctly. So first do them, and if there is any confusion in any question, then you have to take it at last. Jahan pe question bahut zyada confusion ho, turant usko kuch bhi fit mat kariye, uska option soch samajh ke understanding ke sath dobara attempt kar lijiyega, usko chhod ke aage badhna, aur jo aata jayega usko karte jao. क्योंकि एनफ टाइम आपको मिलेगा मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन के लिए, और पेपर का क्राइटेरिया है 25 क्वेश्चंस होंगे, 20 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ 1 मार्क ईच, 20 क्वेश्चन एक नंबर का, एंड 5 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ 2 मार्क्स ईच. सो टोटल 25 क्वेश्चंस एंड द मार्क्स विल बी 30. and 5 lessons are there. We have completed between 6th to 31st July. So lot of questions can be made. So you have to go through entire content once again thoroughly, very carefully. I hope you will obtain best mark. This is a revisional class especially organized for you. I'm not going to discuss the contents once again in this class. After the video will finish, you can ask your question or doubt, you can clear on WhatsApp. The live class WhatsApp, you can ask. Answers will be given to you. So I think if you are preparing all these contents taught to you in the month of July between 6 to 31st July. इतने दिनों में जो कंटेंट आपको अच्छे से पढ़ाया गया है, जो जो लेसन कवर किए गए हैं, उसको खूब बढ़िया से पढ़ना है आपको एक बार थोरली, और जहां पे भी कोई इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट मिले, जैसे कोऑपरेटिव फार्मिंग कहां पे सबसे अधिक सक्सेसफुल हुआ, आपको पढ़ोगे तो मिलेगा, इट इज द डेनमार्क. लाइक दिस यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर ऑल दीज लेसन्स. आई होप यू विल गेट गुड मार्क्स, नॉट गुड, बेटर एंड बेस्ट. बोला जाता है ना, गुड बेटर बेस्ट, नेवर लेट इट रेस्ट, देन योर गुड इज बेटर एंड बेटर विल बी बेस्ट. लगातार परिश्रम करना है, अच्छा से बहुत अच्छा और बहुत अच्छे से सबसे अच्छा नंबर लाना है. गुड बेटर बेस्ट, नेवर लेट इट रेस्ट, देन योर गुड इज बेटर एंड बेटर विल बी द बेस्ट. सो आई होप यू प्रिपेयर सीरियसली. You will take the test seriously. You are in class 12. You have to face the board exam next year. So my all best wishes for the test are here. And I hope you will prepare well also. Jai Hind.